Day 65 of the second run of 100 Days Making Comics. I'm Ox, and this is where I tell you how I've worked on my independent comic, I Never Forgot, about a drifter wanting to accomplish one last goal before he could pass along happily. I equate it to being like The Walking Dead, if it were more about intention and purpose, like that first season was, and not only about survival like it is anymore. The story is taking quite a stroll now, working on issue 4. If you've been paying attention to the last few days, last week actually, I can't even fathom that I've been doing this for a whole week now. Makes sense since I just finished up the 17th page, page 18 for, and the reason that disconnect is because that first page is freehanded when I go to the coloring stage. So the 17th page out of 23 is done. There's 6 to go. Pretty exciting. Pretty exciting stuff. Today I worked on 2 different pages. Got those done. I am starting the next one. Come hell or high water. I hope to get it done tonight because tomorrow I'm actually losing my day for inking. I've got to go watch my nephew. Because it doesn't have a babysitter for the day, so losing that time, but I'm hopefully making up for it. I can knock out this one tonight, hopefully one when I get back tomorrow night. So tomorrow's video will probably be a little later. This should be up about midday because I'll leech off their internet for making me miss a day, and they have better and faster internet, so yeah, there's an even trade-off. I feel like that's an even trade-off. So I got 2 pages done. I worked on those for probably 5-6 hours. You'll be able to see from the timestamps if you pay attention to those. I've knocked the other 2 together from last night. I took the last one that I stayed up this morning doing, and then the one I just finished for the last 3 hours. It's getting a little more detailed, so I'm having to... It's reaching that 3-hour mark rather than that 2-hour mark. I think it would be picked up a little bit if I was just using ink and brush. But I feel like there's things that are too intricate to get in there with the brush, and that's just false. It's more along the lines that I don't trust myself with brush quite as much just yet, and we're getting to really important parts that I don't want to mess up. But so I was telling you yesterday how I like the Prismacolor pen and whatever. I have noticed that the Prismacolor pen tends to not dry as quickly as a Micron. Along those lines, the Prismacolor pen, there were 2 fine tip pens. The one was 0.5 and the other one was 0.05. The 0.05 is not so good, so I really lucked out getting the 5 that works incredible so far. Went through my Microns today. A couple of them just aren't working worth a damn, so it's whatever. They've put up a good run so far. I'm liking how issue 4 is turning out. If you want to pay attention, I'm going to do a whole time lapse of all the pages being inked at the end of this. I'm still debating if I want to do the coloring stages. So if you're liking these inking time lapses, let me know. Maybe I'll continue doing that with the coloring as well. I am probably going to record the inking process, if only to put those up when I put the issue online for when I get caught up to the 4th issue. So either way, they're going to be recorded. I don't know yet if I'm going to be releasing them after the inking process. I'll probably just stop at the inking process. That way it gives you a little tease of what's to come, and then I can kick off that Kickstarter when I get done with the coloring stage. I get it uploaded to Comixology as well. Hopefully hit that mid-November mark for printed books as well as the digital release. So, what else is going on? Since I'm losing the inking day tomorrow, I'm going to get caught up on my schoolwork. Since I've kind of neglected it for about a month, month and a half. All through all of my YouTube stuff. So, I've kind of been spinning my wheels today, trying to find stuff to listen to while I'm inking. There are a few new things. Mike Emmerich's new art therapy cast. I got through a couple new podcasts. And actually, speaking of podcasts, the podcast I was interviewed for a few weeks back is finally online. I'll put the link in the description down below for that. You check that out and listen to it while I currently ink right now. And then, I do dig those guys. They come up with a comprehensive review of the week's worth of comic and nerd news. So, great guys. Check them out. I believe they're based in Canada. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure the podcast is out of Canada. So, with that, check out the podcast. Check out the Chubby Wizard podcast as a whole, but most importantly, check out the podcast I'm interviewed on. I think it came together really well. I've been talking to the guys all day about this and that sort of stuff. Another great thing that has come from the inking process is the ability, since I'm doing the time lapses on my 6 Plus, I have to turn it to airplane mode or I get all kinds of notifications while I'm doing it, and I'm worried about that triggering the time lapse off, so I turn it to airplane mode so I don't even get anything, any notifications. Which is so calming to know that there's that disconnect and that I can just be unadulterated working. So that's nice. I highly recommend it to anyone working in the comics. Let's see if there's anything else. I think after I get done inking issue 4, which 6 pages ago, I lose tomorrow, so Tuesday and Wednesday I should be able to get done with the inking process, which means Thursday I'll most likely be working on the whatchamacallit, working on the variant cover for issue 4. This was the variant cover. It's not exactly what I'm looking for. So this one's getting scrapped. I don't want to paint over it because I do like it, but, it's going to be a similar style. I think the background's basically going to be black. Her dress is going to be purple like it is in the comic. And in this, Stargazer Lily, it's just going to have like a wash, just very faintly pull over like this black and, gray background. I'm pretty excited about getting it done, just because I've been staring at the black and gray painted board for a while now, trying to figure out just what I wanted to do with it. Lightning struck the other night, and I put down all those details down, so I'm going to do that. And then probably Friday, I'll get caught up. Actually, along with Thursday, I'll be doing the giveaway painting for the Kickstarter. I still have to figure out what that is, so at least I have a half a week to figure out what I want to do with that. So then Friday I'm going to be inking 65, probably the whole 25 days. The next print that will be in issue 5. You'll see that whole process. It will probably take an entire day, just because it's such a large print and, you're covering a lot of surface area. I'll be doing brush and ink for that, just to gain some confidence in it still. And that should be right around, 71, 72-ish. So yeah, that's going on. I'm really digging this inking process. The whole thing's just working so well. I highly recommend you sharing your stuff like this. if not only if you're doing these videos to hold yourself accountable only to yourself to make sure you're doing this, it's just one more way of keeping track of exactly how much time you put on it, how much work you're actually putting into a project. Because at the end of the day, you see these inked Bristol boards and it looks like you could do that in 10 minutes, but in all honesty, it takes two and a half hours, 3 hours for some of them. And it's, and mind you, my stuff's not as intricate as most people is. I'm getting there. I will get there. Probably by the 13th issue of this run. A page to ink might take 5-6 hours, so. Crazy stuff. So that's all coming up this week. I hope you're enjoying the time lapses. I'm doing my best to vary the different songs, going through all my genres of music. Feel like people watching these would appreciate. I hope you're getting some good tips. I hope you're liking the process. Gazbot just put up his 18th update. That was pretty good stuff. I'm so excited to see what he comes up with next. On top of that, he's doing a preview. If you want to do support him on Patreon, throw a buck his way a month. I probably will be chipping that in this week at some point. You're not going to get exclusive content, but you are helping support an awesome artist. But he's got this preview of the horror, his comic book, the Horror A4, and I'm so excited to see any of it that, I just want him to finish his comic because I'm so excited to see the whole thing and hold a tangible comic itself. I really dig his work. But this is getting a little long-winded. I know you're dying to see the time-lapse of these two pages, so let's get into that. Before we do, though, check out that podcast I was on. If you're interested, you can get the issue 1 and 2 on my Big Cartel site, samuraiox.bigcartel.com. There are also variants of 1 and 2 as well. You can get both of those. I only have a few left of the first issue variant, so if you are looking for variants, there won't be any more reprinted after these first 25 are gone that I do of each issue. That variant might get pushed up as the Kickstarters go along and I have more people wanting variants. It'll be based on that, how many leftovers I have to sell. So with all that being said, all the links down below for all my social sites, you can find me there. If you're interested in seeing these pages completed, check out my Snapchat. The user is SamuraiOx, just like here on all my other social sites. Instagram and Twitter are seemingly my most active right now. I'm putting the time-lapse little teasers of those there. And then I'm making it public the day of, like 2 days after. So this time-lapse that you're about to see will be fresh on my YouTube channel in 2 days, so just a little buffer zone there. If these people want to see the actual inking process day of, they can watch these whole long-winded videos that are going 14 to 17 to 20 even minutes. So thanks for paying attention, coming here, seeing what's going on with the project. I hope you're digging it all. Throw some comments down below. Let me know what you're interested in seeing over this whole concept project. All that good stuff. I'm looking at getting the trade back together. I have a few great ideas on some exclusive Kickstarter things for that as well. I'll let you know those details as they come in. But for me, that'll do it for me. Day 65 in the books. There are 35 days left to go for the second run of 100 days. Do you think it's possible to do another 100 days? Or should I just go the full year daily updates for comic work? crazy ideas. Anybody that's done this process knows how crazy it is to keep up with these videos. Especially since I'd probably be going to a Gaz tile update where he does it about every week and a half. And he actually records himself every day, what he did, how he's worked on the project and whatnot. So check him out, check out all the other hundreds, find the Facebook group, start your own 100 days. It is well worth it to get into a project and see how much work it takes to get a project off the ground. And if you are able to get through those stages, the sky's the limit. It's been so helpful for me, obviously, doing these two back-to-back. I've been able to push onward with the comic a lot more than I would tend to do normally. I think if I hadn't done the 100 days, I might have really slowed down production on even this second issue, and I wouldn't be nearly as far as I am right now. So all of that is thanks to the hundreds. Check out all the links down below. Check out all that stuff. Get the first couple issues if you want. You can pre-order the third too. That's going to do it for me. I'll check in with you for day 66 of the second run of 100 Days Making Comics for my issue, or for my comic, I Never Forgot. I love you. Hope the weekend treated you well, and I'll check in with you later. Laughing lovers can overcome their closest demons. They'll go on. It's all something that they know. It's never come so close. Can it stay here? Stay here for us? Can it stay till we know ourselves?
Oh, we'll never reach this high.